The Orville, Episode 8, Into the Fold. Yes, finally, a Dr. Claire episode. As a huge fan of the family dynamic element in a sci-fi show, and of course the ties of Dr. Claire Finn's actress to Deep Space Nine, my favorite TV show of all time, this was great. I really like her character, and I loved it in here. I thought everything was portrayed perfectly. I got so many cool flashbacks of watching Jake Sisko growing up during Deep Space Nine. I was the perfect age where I was almost the same age as him. Benjamin Sisko is kind of like a TV father figure for me, and then Cassidy Yates, and obviously a totally different character here, but there's enough of her personality, little elements and things that show up that it felt so relatable to something that is very nostalgic for me, and I just thought her character was great. The kids did a fantastic job. It felt so real, and you could not have had a more perfect pairing than Isaac in this type of thing. The perfect kind of straight man and his trying to understand this family dynamic and things just worked amazingly for me as a premise for an episode. Last week, the Orville tackled a larger social issue, and this week it focuses on a personal drama and primarily the family dynamic. So far, I feel the show's characters and their relationships have easily been the Orville's greatest strength. So I was happy to see an episode focused on those elements unfold flawlessly in terms of its sense of realistic relationships, interesting characters, and stellar humor. Even the somewhat more raunchy humor, entering the glory hole, never felt out of place or character and successfully added to the humor without going over the top. While the Orville is in space dock for repairs, Dr. Claire Finn takes some time off with her sons and plans to take them to a planetary theme park. Due to a conflict with the repairs, Isaac ends up being her co-pilot. The shuttle encounters an anomaly before reaching their destination and is thrown into uncharted space. They are forced to crash land, and in a well-shot and exciting sequence, Dr. Claire is separated from Isaac and her boys. The rest of the episode focuses on the attempted reunion of the separated party and the Orville's attempt to find and rescue them. Claire awakens from the crash, finding herself held captive by Drogon, played by the always reliable Brian Thompson. I swear that man has been in at least one episode of everything I watch. Without spoiling too much, the character of Drogon works wonderfully with Dr. Claire, and the struggles and revelations of Claire are exceptionally engaging and add tremendous tension, along with the threat of radiation and one of her boys getting sick, and provided some real great welcome depth to Dr. Finn's character. I feel like there is a pattern now of every character sort of getting their episode, where the A story primarily focuses on them and revelations of who they really are as a person. Penny Johnson-Gerald really brings her A-game in this episode for my favorite acting performance of the season so far. The interaction of the brothers felt genuine, as did Dr. Claire Finn's role as a mother, and it was all heightened by Isaac's attempts to understand them and his growing relationship with Marcus and Ty Finn over the course of the episode. That particular element stole the show completely. It was endearing, funny, and revealing. The B-story of the crew of the Orville leaving space dock was well done. While it was necessary for the plot, it paled in comparison to the Finn boys, Dr. Claire and Isaac, and everything was balanced perfectly. You did spend far more time on the better A story. The B story was just used to further the plot, and you never lingered too long. It never felt unwelcomed. It came, did what it needed to do, was done well, and left and let the A story continue. It was done very, very well. I think this is one of the better edited episodes overall so far. This episode simultaneously reminded me of my days watching older sci-fi shows as a kid sitting in the living room with my parents, and created new memories of sitting and falling in love with a ship and her crew, their adventures putting me in a positive mood no matter what is happening in this mess of a world, with a sense of wonder at the magic of the universe through the eyes of relatable humanity. This was, without question, my favorite episode so far. This is how you do a fun, relatable sci-fi series.